Let's talk about the rhythmic aspect in Brazilian melodies. One of the elements that draws my attention right away when listening to someone playing Brazilian music is the way the melody is being played in terms of rhythm and time feel. I mean, sure, you can interpret a melody in any ways, regardless the context and kind of music that melody belongs to. That being said, I want to dedicate this video to those interpreters, singers and instrumentalists that want to convey and play Brazilian melodies properly. Brazilian music has many different genres. With that in mind, I want to say that the rhythmic elements I'm going to talk about today are present mostly on samba and can also be heard on forró music, choro and samba bossa nova. Some other rhythms like baião, shot and frevo, for example, have different melodic rhythms, with some other particularities that are more characteristic of those genres. So, for those interested in learning how to interpret Brazilian music with an appropriate rhythm, it's important to first, have a very good sense of rhythm. What I mean is, you have to be precise and sure about where you are placing your notes on the beat. This is super important to play Brazilian music, since this is a type of music that has a lot of syncopation going on, including on the melodies itself. Second, learn the original version plus the most known interpretations of the songs you want to play, if not original music. This is a natural way to learn not only the rhythm, but also dynamics and phrasing. Transcribing and copying is ideal for a better result. Third, learn not only the melody, but what each instrument of the music you are playing is doing or is supposed to do. Mainly percussion parts. You can definitely draw inspiration from that. Most of the Brazilian melodies are based on some kind of common Brazilian rhythm pattern or clave. For example, the tambourine pattern, the brasileirinho, the second and fourth 16th notes pattern. These are examples of patterns that are commonly used in Brazilian melodies. With that in mind, let's look at this samba melody. This is the song Alvorada by Cartola. Notice how the melody is built with 8th notes on top of the 2nd and 4th 16th notes. It's a very syncopated melody, and this is very common in samba music. Let me know if you hear any relation between any kind of clave and the melody. I often see and hear musicians erroneously playing the syncopated rhythms on the downbeat. These are syncopated eighth notes. They're not short notes and they will sound completely different if played as short 16th notes. At last, I want to highlight the relationship between the melody and the tambourine pattern. Note that this melody matches the tambourine pattern playing most of its anticipations, which happens every two bars and also some of the downbeats. Also, even though a lot of the written music found on songbooks may have an accurate representation of how the rhythm of the melody should be played, I strongly recommend checking out the original audio versions of the music and versions played by the true masters of this music. Now, let's check out the song Flor de Lis by Djavan and look closely how he sings and where he places the notes rhythm-wise, mainly when he's singing the transition from the verse to the chorus. É o fim do nosso amor. Perdoa, por favor. Eu sei que o erro aconteceu, mas não sei o que fez tudo mudar de vez. Onde foi que eu errei? Eu só sei que amei, que amei, que amei, que amei. I played this song so many times in my life with so many musicians, Brazilians and non-Brazilians. And it's not everyone that can nail the syncopated melody for this samba. Note how Djavan sings this melody with very few notes falling on the downbeat. The first downbeat only comes on measure 7 on the word erro. Also on measure 17, note how the rhythm from the melody reminds the partido alto percussion pattern. Towards the end of the second verse, the melody is grouped in a 3-note phrasing. This is very common in Brazilian music. Finally, going to the chorus, every little note is syncopated. Again, every little note is syncopated. Let's listen now to Elis Regina singing Brigas Nunca Mais. Note, even though this is a bossa nova, how syncopated she sings this melody, with eventual downbeats.
Chegou, sorriu, venceu, depois chorou. Então fui eu quem consolou sua tristeza, na certeza de que o amor tem dessas fases mais. E é bom para fazer as fases mais.
With the exception of a 16th note that passes by a downbeat on measure 7 on the word sua, the only downbeat comes just on measure 15 and 16 on the words pazes and mais. Also, on the second half of the song, there are a little more downbeats. And now, let's hear the choro Carioquinha by Valdir de Azevedo with Dominguinhos and Yamandu Costa. Many chorinhos have their melody built with arpeggios and scales within groups of 16th notes. In the case of Carioquinha, it's very interesting how the higher notes of these groups are played on the 2nd and 4th 16th notes, highlighting the syncopated pattern very common in Brazilian music. Again, we can see the 3 notes grouping here. Now, let's listen to how Jackson do Pandeiro sings this next song, a forró called Forró na Gafieira. Note, on this forró we have more repeated notes, and also this back and forth of tension and release with the downbeats and upbeats, which is very common on forró music. But that's a topic for another video. For now, let's focus on how Jackson sings this syncopated melody.
Eu fui ver uma gafieira e fiquei em Jacarepaguá. Gostei daquela brincadeira e a semana inteira eu fiquei por lá. Um moreno disse vem cá, entre na dança que a casa é minha. Eu peguei logo uma escurinha e mandei passo de coco e foi chuá.
Right off the bat, we can hear that this forró melody is busier if compared with the other previous example, the samba and the bossa. And this is common for forró music. Also, we can note the extensive use of what the Brazilians called brasileirinho figure, or little fork, which is the rhythm of 1/16th note, 1/8th note, and another 16th note. Also, the 3-note groupings again here towards the end of the chorus. Following, I would like to mention this tool used very often by singers like Jackson himself and others like João Gilberto, which is the skill of manipulating the rhythm of the melody by displacing the phrase or changing the rhythm of the melody by expanding or contracting to make it even more intricate. This is a question I hear very often. Should you play Brazilian music more on top of the beat or should you play more laid back? There's no rules here. Some people play and sing on top of the beat, while others do it more laid back, and some others really push it. I believe, at least among the songs I talked about here, we can say the interpreters tend to be more laid back. My friends, the whole point here is to bring awareness to the way we should play the melody of a song. This is very important to make the music swing and to convey the right feel for the listeners. Lastly, let's syncopate. As one of my mentors, the great Radegundes Feitosa, used to say, you can play the wrong notes, but make sure you get the rhythm right. Ideally, you nail both. Anyways, thanks for watching.